Hi friends, welcome to Hashtagimi. In continuation to our whiteboard recording videos, in this video we will see about concurrent hash map and its internal working in Java. So let's go for it. So when it comes to concurrent, you need to first know what do you mean by concurrency. Concurrency in Java or is said that when multiple threads they perform multiple tasks simultaneously, then concurrency does occur. So in situations in which a hash map needs to work in a multi-threaded environment, so to achieve the thread safe nature, concurrent hash map comes into picture. So let's assume that there are list of nodes. As you know, though, there are several nodes, and the initial size of concurrent hash map is also 16. Load factor is 0.75. This consists of 16 buckets. As it consists, there is a linked list of 16 buckets. These are all 16. This is the first node. This is the 16th node. Now, each node of a linked list consists of 4 parts that are key, value, hash code, and next. So key basically contains the key for the particular element, V contains the value, and hash code used to identify on which location it needs to be placed in the bucket list, and this is the next part. So consider, as I told you, in the multi-threaded environment, there are multiple threads like T1, T2, T3. So consider these 3 threads are there. Now situation arises in which in the fourth node, there are 3 elements. So in the fourth node there are 3 elements, 10, 12, 14, and they are in the form of list and they point to each other as the normal linked list function works. So also there are values like 101, 102, and 103. So consider that T1 needs to update this value and T3 needs to update this value simultaneously. So for that, how is it possible using the regular map? No, it's not possible using regular maps. For that, we need concurrent hash maps. Here, concurrent hash map comes into picture. So what we'll do, it will lock the entire fourth node itself. So entire fourth node is locked. It will not lock the entire size of the hash map or 16 buckets at a time. Will lock only the specific node in which concurrent operations need to be done, like multiple updates or multiple deletes node for node. That for that we need to lock that specific node in that bucket list. So it will obtain lock over there, and it will with the help of that lock, it will concurrently able to update or delete the nodes in the concurrent hash map. So basically, to support this concept, we have, it resolves the concurrent modification exception. There are also there's fail-safe iterators. Fail-safe iterators fail-safe iterators. With the help of concurrent hash map, you are able to resolve the most important exception that might occur if any other kind of hash map is, that is concurrent modification exception. It occurs basically when you are trying to update or delete hash map value when parallelly we are performing some other like get or other operations in it. So in that way it helps to resolve the concurrent modification exception. Let's move further. The load factor is 0.75. So when the you say 75% of the entire hash map is filled, and basically it doubles itself in size. So to the existing 16 nodes, the new node is up. The new list of 16 nodes is appended, and it maintains a node. Suppose this is our first list of 16 nodes, 0, 1, up to, these are first list of 16 nodes. So I will note these as, let's say, hash map 1. So when let's say 75% of which let's say 12 of its nodes are filled, then it will resize itself using the load factor as the load factor of 0.75. so what it will do, it will maintain a node called as forwarding node. So it contains a value called as -1. So what this -1 will do, it when this -1 will occur, -1 value will occur, it will get to know that the you need to include some other list in the table, list of nodes in the table. So it this minus will act as a, you can say, as a pointer or a reference value to the concurrent hash map to point to the next node. So it will, -1 will store the next series of values. It basically copy the base node and it will store the next series of values into the this new series of linked list of 16 nodes. So this act as a guiding factor in forwarding node. Note that the vendor, it also supports the concept of Java 8, that is the treefy. So when eight or more number of collisions occur, then it using the treefy threshold, and that specific need arises to maintain multiple nodes or multiple times load factoring needs to be done. So that was about concurrent hash map and its internal working. So how does it also solve the concurrent modification exception? So do keep liking, subscribing, hashtag Kimit. More videos going on such internal design principle explanation related videos. Bye for now.